In listen-only mode.
Greetings everyone and welcome in this webinar. Today we will be discussing about the concepts and the components of a health and safety management system. My name is Suzana Yete, the PCB organizer of this webinar, and the guest for today is Mr. Raza Shah, PCB certified trainer who is a senior consultant, trainer and coach in occupational health and safety. Please write your questions and comments in the question box in the right-hand control panel, and Mr. Shah will answer to them accordingly. Moreover, if you want to participate directly with Mr. Shah in the discussion, you can also raise your hand, and then we will unmute you so you can make your questions directly to him. Please, Mr. Shah, you may start the presentation.
Okay. Thank you, Suzana. I am Raza Shah from Pakistan. I am lead editor for ISO 9000, ISO 14000, OSHA's 18000, and I am advanced editor for SA 8000. Today, we are going to discuss some basic component of health and safety. Throughout this seminar, we will discuss the basic concepts of occupational health and safety based on OSHA 18001, and after this you will be able to understand the concepts and components of health and safety management system, and we will discuss the basic structure of occupational health and safety OSHA 18001. So first of all, we will define the health and safety management system. Basically, the meaning of the health and safety management system means which an organization control risk through management process, how an organization control the risk through its management. And it is the part of the overall management system that facilitates the management of occupational health and safety risk associated with the business of the organization. This includes organization structure, planning, activities, responsibilities, practices, procedures, processes, resources for developing and achieving, reviewing and maintaining the organization occupational health and safety policy. So it includes planning and activities, responsibilities, practices, procedure, processes, resources, and reviewing the and maintaining the occupational health and safety policy. So this is basically the based on the system approach. The system approach consists of the four elements. The four elements common to general system theories are input, processes, output, and feedback. Systems are normally are also closed and begin either open or closed. Open system interact with the external environment and is subject to external influences. Closed system do not interact with the environment, and so their ability to adapt or respond to changing internal condition is limited. So there are two types of the system. One is the open system, which change according to the external environment, and the second is the closed system, which do not have the ability to change according to the external environment. So better is this, that you have open system which can be changed according to the requirements of the external environment. And if we see this slide, this is showing the system approach. System approach started with input, then some processes, and then after this process some output comes, and then feedback, and then again input. So it is a continuous process starting from input and then processes and then output and feedback. And this system approach is taken place within the organization and external environment have also impact on this system approach. We cannot take this system without the impact of the external approach, external environment. So this is the whole system approach. Most of you are familiar with this approach, and you can see this is a continuous process. Arrows are showing that it is not ending anywhere, and the whole organization have impact on this approach, this system, and external environment has also impact on this approach. So you can see on this slide some key elements of health and safety management system. These are starting from the policy, and then organizing, and then planning and implementation, and then measuring performance and reviewing performance. And for every element, we have a check and balance system through audit. For every element, we are doing the audit. It is starting from the policy and ending with the reviewing the performance. And for each element, we are performing the audit. So this is the basic elements of any health and safety management system. You have to define the policies, you have to organize the structure, and you have to plan the system and implement it, and you have to measure the performance, and then you have to review the performance. And you can see this is also a continuous process. The arrows are going upward, and you can change the policy, and even you can change the organization, or you can change the plan according to the requirement. So this is also a continuous process. So if we see, you can see the elements step by step. The first element is the policy. Policy is basically effective health and safety policies set a clear direction for the organization to follow. So policies are basically guidelines, what is to do or what is not to do. So these are the policies for health and safety policies that give direction to the organization, which organization have to follow, and that what we can do and what we cannot do. And the next element in this slide is the organizing. So if we see that it is coming after the policy. So an effective management structure and arrangements are in place for delivering the policy. So organizing is basically the arrangement and structure for delivering the policy. What we have said in the policy, through organizing and structuring, we will implement or deliver these policies. And the next, you can see the next element is the planning. And planning is basically